Hey, this is Matthias here from WinSeries.ai, and today I'll show you how you get TikTok ads data into Google Sheets. Let's get started. As a first step, you go to onboard.winSeries.ai, and in here, you search for TikTok. Once you're in here, you click Grant TikTok Access, and then you log in with your TikTok account. Do make sure that your account is linked to the ad account you want to connect. Then you click Confirm, Authorize Success, and then you're redirected back here. In here, you'll see your TikTok accounts in a dropdown. Now I can go into Data Preview, and then over here, you can select the data source. In your case, it will only be TikTok. Here I also have other sources set up, but that's the data I want. Now you see that there is data in the preview, so this looks good. The next step, you can install the Google Sheets add-on by clicking on Google Sheets, install the Google Sheets add-on. Once this is done, you open a new sheet. And then here in the extensions menu, you can move down to WinSeries.ai, click on login for the first time, and then you paste your API key. You can find your API key down here. Once you're logged in, there will be this menu here, Get Data into Sheet, and click on it. And now the sidebar should open. Now it's time to build the query. The query is done in a similar way as it is done over here. So we just go and select the query name, which I call TikTok. And then we specify the target sheet, which is sheet one. Then here I specify the data source again. I would like to get TikTok data over. Now here you can select an account or you can skip that. In case you skip the account selection step, all the accounts you have connected will be pulled in, which is what I want. And then you select the data range. Now in my case, I only have data in a very specific time range because it's a test account. So I would click on custom date range here. And then I go to 2022, somewhere around July to August 31st, 2022. Now I click on load data, or I could also specify different fields in case I want. Then select filters, data options, or I can automate the refresh here by selecting a refresh interval, which I'm also going to skip now. Then I click load data. Then we should get the same data like we have in the data preview. So now the data is here. And now this data can be used subsequently in building and creating reports. Thanks very much for watching and enjoy working with our connectors.